In the previous video, we looked at optimizing replication. In this video, we will look at vSphere data protection appliance, installation and configuration. We will look at the actual installation process for the vSphere data protection appliance and then its configuration. During the installation of the appliance, there was some troubleshooting that had to be done, and this is something that is quite common that people encounter when they install vSphere data protection appliance. So it's good to know ahead of time what you might be looking at in terms of troubleshooting. So we are logged in into the vSphere web client once again. We are at the local site, site.local, which is our headquarters site. We are going to go through and do a quick review of the user interface of the VDP. So when you go to the home page, you see an icon VDP, and you can click on that. And this is the home screen that actually comes up. A few basic tasks. You can download an application backup client. This is for SharePoint Exchange and SQL Server. Obviously, one of the key activities one has to do is to create a backup job. And then there's a capability to automatically verify a backup. And we will show you that as well after creating a backup job. And then, of course, to restore a backup as well. So one would go in here into the backup tab, and then this is the backup job that already exists. And if we click on that and edit that to see what the various things are that are in place. So the type of backup that I wish to perform is a full image backup, and I will fall back to a non-quiesced backup if quiescence fails, so it tries to quiesce the file system first. Of course, the backup, I'm only backing up Windows Server 16. I can obviously have those as well. Separate backups are better because my schedules might be different. Speaking of schedules, the Windows Server 2016 is backed up daily, and it is backed up at 8 p.m. Next is the retention policy. I keep the backups for 60 days. The other options are, of course, I can keep them forever, which people would not normally do, unless it is for some specific business purpose. We will look at the other options when we actually create new backup jobs. The backup job name must be unique. And then just a quick review. The name of the job, what are the VMs, which are the selected sources, where are you backing it up? Well, the VDP appliance storage. VDP already has a bunch of storage attached to it. There's a backup schedule and a retention policy. So I will cancel out of that because I don't want to change this right now. So that's how one would create a backup job or edit a backup job. Let's look at the actions again. You can create a new one, you can edit it, you can clone this and then massage it, you can delete it, you can enable and disable it, which means you can, you know, have it still there, not deleted, but not functional, not enabled, and you can later on come back in and actually enable it. You have the option of backup now as well. I actually utilized that a few times just to be able to get a few more images to show you in the restore tab. Now, backup verification is a very powerful feature. What backup verification does is that once the backup is done, it takes the system, VDP, the data protection appliance, takes that backup and restores it to another location that one specifies. And then it runs backup verification scripts and so on, if necessary, to make sure that the proper return code, which is a zero, actually comes back from the scripts. If there are no scripts, then it basically fires it up and brings it back down again and looks for a heartbeat. In some cases, the heartbeat is not found, so you can get erroneous errors in the sense that, you know, it would be a false positive. But it is an extremely powerful way of at least making sure that your backup is good, because you are at least able to start up the virtual machine from it. And that is a good thing to have. The job actions here again are, you can create a new backup verification job. And once that's created, of course, you know, the other items that are grayed out right now would be enabled again. So a very similar interface as with the backup tab, this one. The next one is the restore tab. And of course, the backups that we've been doing are of the Windows Server 2016. And this is where it actually resides. The backup type is an image type. The actual user interface process is a little bit different because this is an EMC AVAMAR product, vSphere Data Protection. So one has to click on this arrow to be able to get down into the number of backups that are available for this Windows server. And then when I click on that again, it goes down further, and basically there's one disk that has been created in the backup. So I go, and this is the way you go back. Interface is a little bit different. Another interesting option here is recover replicated backups. So one of the very powerful features of data protection is that after backing it up, you can then replicate that backup to another vSphere data protection site. Now, we are going to do this later because I have set up a second site at which we will install a vSphere data protection appliance, and I'll go through the process with you to install it and configure it. And then we will use that site to replicate our backups from this primary site. And to set up those replicated backups, of course, that's what you do. Again, options are very, very similar. You have to create a new replication where you define what the destination is essentially and what the sources of those backups. The reports tab gives you the overall information, and the other interesting pieces are the task failures in the last 72 hours, the job details of jobs recently run, and then the unprotected clients, which would be the list of virtual machines that are under this vCenter that are not being backed up. And as you can see, all of them are not being backed up, all except the Windows Server 2016. Click on configuration gives you some really interesting information. So first of all, here you get the backup appliance details. So it's a VDP 6.1. Its IP address is 60. We saw this, or we will see this later on as well. It's running on the host 201, and the vCenter server is 220. Also, the VDP backup username and so on. On this side, it's very interesting because VDP is very sophisticated. It does variable length blocks and does dedupes as well based on that. So you can see that the capacity of disk that I allocated to the VDP when I first installed this was quite large, 536 gigabytes. Out of those four Windows Server 2016 backups, the non-dedupe size would have been 40 gig. But instead, because of deduplication, the size is only 9 gigs. So 536.3 minus 9 is 527.3 gigs. So the dedupe works quite well. This section is about downloads, which is where you download the agents for Exchange Server, SharePoint, SQL Server 32-bit and 64-bit that one can then utilize from within an Exchange, SharePoint, or a SQL Server system so that the data protection appliance can work with it at an application quiescing basis. And then very granular level GLR, not just file level, but GLR level restores are possible, based on based on tables and so on and various entities within these application servers. Scrolling down a little bit, this is the backup window configuration that can be edited and that can be changed as well. The log and the email, and it's giving me an error for some reason. The reason I was getting that edit error is because this was hidden on the bottom right hand side of the screen out of sight due to the limitation I have on the screen size for this, or the resolution, screen resolution for this video. So I basically have to cancel out of it, and then of course, I'm able to go back and forth as I had tried to do earlier. So by clicking on that, the log file, and this enables alarm email notification and reports, and it sends reports as a CSV attachment if necessary to wherever it is that it needs to, as well as the login credentials that are actually required to do that. You can also send a test email. Obviously, something very useful for folks that have to worry about making sure that backups have worked and that there are no alarms. There are different alarms and things that can also be set up, but that's part of a different section of this course. We're running only one vSphere data protection appliance. If we were running others, this drop down would show those as well. And by clicking on this green button, that's where we would actually switch to. All actions, I could disconnect from this appliance, this data protection appliance. Again, this being an EMC AVAMAR product, the concept is a little bit different from, for example, the vSphere replication appliance, where you're generally connected always to it. So this is a quick tour of the user interface of the VDP. And what I'm going to do later on is to install another VDP on a different server. And then what we will do is we will actually replicate to it. In the next video, we will look at the vSphere data protection appliance user interface and do a lab tour so that you are completely familiar with how to use vSphere data protection appliance. I look forward to seeing you there.